The car is originally my grandpa's, and then the car was eventually given to me. I thought it was only right to keep it in the family and give it to my son. My name is Jose Alvarez, and I'm the owner of Fatal Attraction, a 1972 Monte Carlo. Me as a kid growing up, I was into, you know, the model cars and the lowrider bikes, but I never thought I would be able to build a car like that. So my original plans for the car was just to pretty much clean up the engine compartment and paint it and make it nice and clean and put a little chrome here and there. But I pulled the engine out. And then when it was out, I was like, man, I might as well just drop the frame and do the frame. And then so I dropped the frame and it turned into a full frame off restoration. I pretty much took it down to bare metal, and I was partially doing body work with Juan Hurtado in Santa Paula at a show status. And I would take him a fender and he would do the body work on the fender. And then when he was done, I would pick it up and drop the other fender off, and then he would do the body work, and it just kept going, like a hood, a trunk, until the point where the actual body needed body work because I had customized the roof and the skirts and stuff like that. If you look at the roof towards the back, on a 70 through 72 Monte Carlo, it's more box. What I did is I cut the roof to make it look like a fastback 67 Impala, and cap the windows in to just make it look more sleek and flow with the roof and the body line. So the window was actually here, and the this was all metal. You know, I just got a marker and marked it like that, and I sat back and I was like, man, I want to do that. So then I kind of just followed the line here, kind of, and then went that way with it. But I did this, capped the windows in so there's no windows on the side, and then I molded the skirts to make the quarter panel like look longer. So the original one usually comes up here and it's removable, but I welded it on there and I made it, you know, molded it to the body and shaved the handles. So it just looks more custom, but unless you know Monte Carlo, you won't notice things like that. So I added a 42 inch moonroof to the roof just to let the sun in and be able to just let more wind in. Even though I don't have side windows, I wanted to be able to look up at the moon or the open it and let the sun come in. And we cut it in Santa Paula at a Juan Hurtado shop show status. Kevin did all the metal work and fabricated it. It needed body work, so I took the body to him. He went over the body work again to make sure that the doors and the fenders and the quarter panels and everything matched, and it was like razor sharp and straight. The car was originally green, and I was gonna paint it the original color again, but then I just decided, you know what? I already did the roof and the skirts and shaved the handles and all this. I gotta go candy. So I told them I wanted candy lime gold, and I want patterns, I want flake. He just said, you know what, let me lay some tape down. He had one whole side done of just tape, and I was like, yeah, that looks nice. I told him, you know what, I'm gonna leave it in your hands and you just pretty much just go for whatever you wanna do. The patterns needed to stand out from the paint, and it needed pinstriping. Danny D at a Baldwin Park, he added the fingerprint pattern and all the striping and leafing on the car. Originally, I wanted to paint the car the color of like antifreeze, like that green, greenish yellow color, like a bright green. Just the base coat is a planet green with a candy lime gold over it. The car was based, and then it was cleared, patterned it, and then he shot the candy over all the patterns. The candy is transparent. So when you lay it down, you're still seeing the graphics, but they're changing because of the colors you use and the flakes and all that. So it's making different colors as he lays it down. The car was painted and I looked at it and I was like, what am I gonna do for the interior? I have to do something custom, because it's just, the car is too custom to have an original dash. So I wanted something different. I wanted my gauges in the middle of the dash, and I wanted a center console out of metal. We went from the center console and worked our way to the dash, and I kind of just told him what I wanted and how I envisioned it, and he knows how to work metal really good, and he took about a month to do the dash and cap, you know, the windows and the rear package tray. And that was already done after the car was painted, so I had to take it back to the paint shop and have them do bodywork on the whole dash to match the outside of the car. I decided to go with the full custom interior because the outside of the car was just fully custom, and I couldn't go with the stock interior. It would just throw the whole car off. So I knew it needed something to flow with the car. When you go to a car, the first thing that grabs you is the paint, and the second thing is the interior. The interior was done by California Upholstery and Bell Gardens. I want to say one of their first interiors that they did before they got really, really busy. I removed the headrest from the seats, painted the back of the seats, and pinstriped them. They're from an original 72 Monte Carlo sport coupe. Joe from California Upholstery made some, you know, custom door panels. And then the headliner is all suede custom headliner, because there's no drip rails or anything like that to hide the seams. They put a lot of work into the headliner. I came up with the colors, and I didn't know if I wanted to go a darker green or a lighter green. So I found this green, which is like a pistachio green, which is like a tan of greens. And I thought it looked just perfect with the paint. It wasn't taking away from the paint. It was just kind of like down a tone and more mellow. And so they did the interior. I had Renee at R&R Upholstery in Saticoy redo the carpet, because it was light and it was getting just dirty. So he redid the carpet. The motor is pretty much stock, just rebuilt, painted candy lime gold. And I added a street and performance pulleys and serpentine kit. Everything's chrome or polished. When I was showing it, it did have a tune port injection, which looked beautiful, but it just performed really poorly. So I removed that and went back to carbureted. I added the EnduroShine manifold, carburetor, air cleaner, and just got it running way better, but still looking really nice in there. And it's just pretty much a stock 350, but dressed in chrome and shiny. The suspension is pretty much stock, just chromed. All I did was weld up the holes that you could see when you in the front wheel well and the rear wheel well area, just so that it looked clean when I locked it up and you looked in there. It was just nice and flush. The A-arms are fully molded. The ball joints are all capped in, so the A-arms are just clean. You can't see any bolts or anything on them. Yeah, they're fully molded and extended 5/8, the uppers. And the lowers are just fully molded as well. And just everything's chrome plated by Victor's best chrome and polish out of Pomona, California. My hydraulic setup is a whammy pro hopper tank, which is pretty much two pumps and into one. I have four batteries. Right now that I'm driving it, I'm making everything more accessible and easier to work on and stuff like that. So I recently decided to make some chrome racks, put them in the trunk, make them nice and accessible and easy to charge, and just easier to be able to drive. It was just coming together so fast after the hydraulics were in and all the moldings and stuff like that. It was just going really fast. I can remember going days without sleeping or falling asleep in the car, under the car. I lived in the Candy Connection warehouse all the way up until the weekend of Las Vegas. We finished it that weekend. It was on a Friday and the sun was coming up and we were working on it, putting stuff together, wiring, taking the interior out, putting it back in and making sure the hydraulics work. And I didn't want to really start it too much because the exhaust starts turning colors and I wanted to show it on jackstand. So we pushed it out on the street and pushed it up on the trailer. When we got to the Las Vegas Super Show, we rolled it off the trailer and I was about to drive in and the car wouldn't go into gear. Well, the guy that built my motor didn't put the bolts on the flywheel and it wouldn't go into gear. So we had to push the car into the show and the judges, everybody seen that we were pushing it, and to compete in the Las Vegas Super Show, you have to roll forward, roll backwards, and then you could compete. So they pretty much disqualified me, but it didn't bother me because my car was already on jack stands at the Las Vegas Super Show, and that was winning for me. That was my trophy. I had a fatal traction at the Peterson Automotive Museum in 2017. It was there for 4 or 5 months. A LowRider exhibition show in their main lobby. It felt good being able to show the car on display, you know, day and night. It was at the window, you could drive by and just anybody could see it. It was just an honor for my car to be in there with, you know, these $100,000 cars. I thought it was pretty cool. My car came out on LowRider Magazine. The 2011, it was a double car feature with Psychotic Pineapple. And then in 2012, it was just strictly fatal traction on the front cover. For me to be on the cover of LowRider Magazine was just like a dream as a kid growing up, reading the magazines and looking at them. And I never thought my car would be on the cover of LowRider Magazine, but I wasn't sure when they were gonna release it. They kind of just shot it and they didn't tell me what month or anything like that. And one of my buddies called me and he said, "Hey, have you went to 7-Eleven or Circle K or anything like that lately?" And I was like, "No, why? Your car's on the cover of LowRider Magazine." I was like, "What, already?" So I went to 7-Eleven and yeah, there was front cover. Everybody was like, "Hey, your car's on the magazine." And I was like, "Oh shit, that was fast." Like, I wasn't expecting it to be that fast because I think it was like 2 months later and I thought it was gonna be like a year or something out. I don't know how long it took, but it was nice being able to see it on the magazine. This car was a trailer queen for the first 2 years. Went from on and off the trailer, pushing it and just to try to preserve the exhaust and the chrome and the paint and the wheel wells and things like that so that I could show it and it looked clean. And I kind of got burnt out of just cleaning and polishing and showing, and it was just kind of getting old. I decided to just get my car roadworthy, and I've been driving it and enjoying it and getting paint chips and not caring. And you know, right now I'm enjoying it. Why have a car of that caliber and not be able to enjoy it and drive it in the streets? That's where the real show's at. It's not in the car shows. When you show your car just cruising, that's the real show. I love just being able to get in the car, start it, the smell, lifting it, driving off, and just being able to drive and pull up to a light and just see people's reactions when they roll up next to you. I like to, you know, get the family in the car and just go for a cruise. Pretty much you're just out there and you're just having fun and you forget about time. And I always wanted to have a son and name him something that was unique. I picked the Chevy and she picked the middle name, which is Carlo, like a Monte Carlo. So his name's Chevy Carlo Alvarez. The car is originally my grandpa's car. The car was given to my dad and then the car was eventually given to me. Now I thought it was only right to keep it in the family and give it to my son. He's starting to take care of it and telling everybody, you know, this is my car, you know, when I get older it's gonna be mine. And he likes to sit in it with, when kids come over, he'll be like, Dad, can we sit in there and hit the switch and put some music on? Can I change it, you know, the music? And he just loves it. When you're cruising, you don't worry about anything. You're just rolling, just listening to music, cruising, hitting switches, and that's all you think about. Forget about everything. To me, cruising is really what I love about lowriding.